fighting against cancer and help raise money to find a cure. I want to continue my mother's legacy tonight. Will you help me? Will you dig deeply into your hearts and into your wallets? One of my favorite memories with her is when we would go shopping together. It was so funny because when we would go shopping, she would see something that she liked and she'd buy it in every color and every size. I guess you could say she was a compulsive shopper. Even when we moved from our house in Las Vegas, we found a whole bunch of clothes that still had the tags on them because she just bought so much. I never got the chance to wear them. In fact, we ended up donating all the clothes we found that didn't fit me anymore to people in need. She was also the kind of shopper that knew what to look for. People would always tell her that she should teach a course called Shopping 101 because she was so good at it. Yes, my mother was a power shopper, buying things in every color, and I do the exact same thing to this day. Because our house in Vegas was so big, I was used to having half of the house being called Chantal's wing. When I was little, I always had a nanny. And at the time, I just thought the nannies would help take care of me and to help my mom out around the house. But little did I know that the reason we had a nanny was not only to help take care of me, but was to help take care of my mom because she was so sick. My mom always planned the best birthday parties for me. It was one of her favorite things to do. She always went all out from all the decorations to getting all my favorite characters to show up. In fact, my last fond memory of my mom was at my 6th birthday party. She passed just 8 days after I turned 6 years old. At my mother's funeral, I didn't cry. And it wasn't because I didn't care, it was because I thought she was going to come back. When we were at the funeral, I was standing next to my brother-in-law, Jody, and he said to me, "Chantal, are you okay? You're not crying." And I said, "It's okay, she's going to come back in a couple of days, just like Jesus did." I said that because the school I was going to at the time was a Lutheran school, and I had learned all about Jesus and how he came back from the dead after a couple of days. So I thought that if he came back, my mom would come back too. After her funeral, it took me a couple months to realize that she was actually gone and she was never coming back. Everyone would be crying and all upset, so I would cry with them even if I didn't know what they were crying about. So when I finally realized why everybody was crying, it was about a few months after her funeral. It's so sad to think of all the things my mom has missed since then. I'm just glad she at least got to make it to my kindergarten graduation. However, she's missed my elementary school graduation, my middle school graduation, all of my award ceremonies, my 8th grade dance.
She's your baby.
Mm-hmm. My first homecoming, all of the amazing opportunities I've had throughout my life. It's also sad to think of all the things she's going to miss in my future, like my high school graduation, all of the rest of my award ceremonies, my first prom, my wedding day, and the birth of my kids. She would never get to meet her future grandchildren, and I know she would have loved the day she would become a grandma. One of the greatest things that has happened in these past few years is that my dad found an amazing wife named Kay. She has taken me under her wing like her own daughter and cared for me. I know my mom wanted my dad to find a mom for me. She told my dad before she passed that she wanted him to find a mom for me. It's so great that my dad found Kay because she has a very similar personality to my mother. She has the same loving care that she did and the same determination to get things done. I'm so grateful that my dad found her. I finally live in a house with two parents. And it's the best feeling in the world. We are a family now, and together we are working to honor my mom's legacy. My dad, Alex, is the chairperson for Making Strides Against Breast Cancer. My mom, Kay, is the chairperson for Real Men Wear Pink. And I am volunteering and working with ACS to give back. It brings me such joy to help others and give back at a time of personal crisis. I know how it feels, and others helped me when I was going through this myself. I know my mom is watching down on me and very proud. My mom always liked to look at the bright side of things. So when she was sick and had lost all her hair, she said to me, "At least I don't have to worry about shaving my legs and underarms anymore." So now I ask you, please open your hearts and open your wallets and give generously of your money and time to the Making Strides campaign.